That's Genesis 2:18. These items will be returned to the proper owner or owners if they have the right credentials.
Chocolate, Oklahoma. The unprecedented cold weather of the summer has produced a condition that has not yet been satisfactorily explained. There's a report that a wall of ice moving south across these counties, but the disruption of communication has now rendered exact information difficult. For further information, see your daily news feed.
Excelsior Times.
Sabrina, take this fire and we'll light this double. So what are they saying about this cold weather?
Well, of course I don't know anything, but they say there's a wall of ice moving from the north. It moves everything in front of it, from churches to post offices to city hall.
And what are people doing?
Well, talking mostly. Some are trying to go south, but the roads are crowded. You can't take children and old people home like this.
And what's this telegram that you have for me?
You can just give me a second. To Miss Andrews, Excelsior, Texas. My dear wife, we'll be an hour late. Busy day at the office. Don't worry the children about the cold. Burn everything except Shakespeare. Have made great discoveries today. Have separated M from N.
I know what that is. That's the alphabet. Yes, it is. Oh, Mrs. Andrews is just the cleverest man. What? When he's done with the alphabet, we'll be able to tell the future and everything.
Then get this. Tens make 100 semicolons. Consequences for reaching.
The world is turning to ice, and all he can do is make up new numbers? What does he say next?
Well, I can't get this part correctly. I'm running out of words. Kill you! I'm running out of words.
What does anybody do about it?
old Papa's little gopher.
And Henry, nothing rash today, I hope. Nothing rash.
Papa, you're always teasing me.
No, Papa.
Sabrina, there's some food for you. Hi, Mr. Miller, the fire belongs to.
Mr. Yantrovitz, I've given my notice. I'm leaving 2 weeks from today. I'm sorry, but I'm leaving.
Well, if you leave, you're freeze to death. So go in the kitchen and make dinner.
2 weeks! That's the law.
Did you get my telegram?
Yes, what's so clean of? What about this cold weather? It's below freezing.
Not before the children.
Shouldn't we do something before I move?
Not before the children!
Oh! Papa, you hit me!
That's to make you remember today. Today was finished. And the day we saw the hundreds. The hundreds, the hundreds, the hundreds. There is no end to them. Maggie, take a good look at this wheel for a reward for all the walking you've been doing. Yes, we've done it. We've reached the top of the wave. Maggie, there's nothing more to be done. We're there.
And the ice.
The ice.
You can put a chair on it.
Yes, any movie can pull with it now, but I thought of it first.
Should you go out into the kitchen? I want to talk to your father alone.
Thank you.
Matthew, these people never give up. They think they'll live and work forever.
Thank you.
were set at the assembly, did you?
Yeah.
You didn't forget?
No, I was perfect. The fins, the shells, and the furs, and so on.
than many of us here. But for the last many years, I have remained the Empress.
Whether or not
calm down.
No, I hate this place. I wish I wasn't here. I wish I wasn't anywhere.
Henry, you're being so petty for nothing. Everybody, let's all bring this ever happen. Let's all take a deep breath of the fresh sea air and calm down, okay?
Maggie?
Did you know the ocean is 360 million?
Bingo.
Now, you just stretch out in there. I won't say a word.
Oh, Miss Fairweather, you'll spoil me.
Just a moment. I have something I want to say to the audience.
Certainly, what?
Ladies and gentlemen, am I going to be playing this part of the scene tonight? It's just a quick scene, and I'll tell you what happened.
Yeah!
been taught to any man, and it's never been taught to any woman. And if it finds its destination, a new time will come. We're not what the books and plays say that we are. We're not what the advertisements say that we are. We're ourselves, and if any man can find any one of us, he'll understand why the whole universe was set into motion. And if any man harms any one of us, his soul, the only soul he's got, had better be at the bottom of that ocean. And that's the only way to put it!
Mr. Andrew!
They may be hiding out back. Mrs. Antrobus! Gladys, come out, please!
Over here.
Thank you.
light over there. And I think something's burning. Denton, or Roy City. Yeah, I could have sworn I heard somebody up here, but I can't see them. Yeah, I said I can't see them.
Mama, be careful. Gotta stay out of sight.
Let me stay here just a minute. I want the baby to get some of this fresh air.
Fine, but keep your eyes sealed. I'll see what I can find, and I'll make your soup faster than you can say, Chef Larry. Gladys Antipas, do you see what I think I see over there? Oh, Mr. Hawkins, sweeping at the front of his Kroger store with a broom. Why, he must have gone insane, just like the others.
I'm a compat, just compat.
Gladys, the air is different. It's making people move differently, too. Why, there's even girls walking right down in the middle of the street!
Mrs. Antrobit! Gladys!
Come out! Gladys, that's Sabina's voice. I know that's Sabina's voice. Sabina! Sabina, where are you? Sabina, are you alive?
Of course I'm alive!
Oh, how have the girls been?
Oh, hi! Oh, don't try and kiss me. I never want to be kissed by another human being as long as I live.
Take a deep breath. The war's over.
The war is over?
The war is over.
Yeah.
I can't believe you.
I don't believe you.
Mama!
It's almost bad.
As glad as it'll be.
Oh, there is
a war in the world.
Oh, can't see it. Can't cry. He notices everything very well.
Oh, well, where on earth did you get it?
Oh, I won't ask. Lord knows I've been on the camp for 7 years, and I've forgotten how to behave. Now, look. We've got to think about the men coming home. Mrs. Antrobus, go and wash your face. I'm ashamed of you. Put on your best clothes. Mr. Antrobus will be here this afternoon.
So you're not joking.
He's alive.
He's alive.
He's Harry. Yeah, he's alive too. Now don't stop the talk. Just go and get washed up. Oh, Gladys, you look horrible.
Well, I have some clothes to change into. We've been sitting here just for this very day. Won the war.
Don't stop to talk. Just go and get it washed up.
Yeah. My, what's that silly little noise? What is that?
Is it that?
The new whistle at the shoe polish factory.
That's what it is.
Seems to me like peacetime coming along pretty fast. Sabina, how soon after peacetime begins does the milkman start coming to the door?
As soon as he catches the cow. Give him time to catch a cow, dear. Oh, Mrs. Antrobus. You'll never guess what I saw Mr. Antrobus doing this morning at dawn. Oh, he was typing up a piece of paper on the door of the town hall.
You'll die when you hear.
It was a recipe for grass soup. For a recipe that doesn't give you diarrhea. Mr. Antrobus is still thinking of new things. He told me to give you his love. He's got all sorts of ideas for peacetime, he says. No more
You should hear him talk.
Well, these are in English anyways.
To hear him talk seems like he expects you, Mrs. Angelus, to be a combination of a saint and a college professor and a dance hall hostess. If you know what I mean.
German.
What did they ever care about me?
There's that old line again. All you people think that you're not loved enough. Nobody loves you. Well, you start being lovable and we'll love you.
I don't want anybody to love me.
Then stop talking about it all the time.
I never talk about it. Last thing I want is for anybody to pay any attention to me.
I can hear it in every word you say.
I want everybody to hate me.
Yes. You've decided that's second best. But it's still the same thing.
Yes, I've been sitting in. Oh, it is very late. Two big potatoes. Henry, no, please. where you stood.
When are you gonna wake up?
Hey, go back to sleep. Go back to sleep.
Everything down. Everything. Everything! I don't care what you smash, what you break. I don't care. We're gonna begin again and we're gonna show them. We'll show them. Do it. Don't think I'm afraid of you. Do what you were going to do. Shoot me. Don't think I'm any son of yours. I don't have a father, or brothers, or sisters. And what's more, I don't want any. I'm alone. That's all I will ever be. Alone. You can shoot me. You're the last person I want to see. Just a silence dries up all my plans and hopes. I wish we were still back at war because it's easier to fight you than to live with you. War's a pleasure. Do you hear me? War's a pleasure compared to what faces us now, trying to build up a peace time with you in the middle of it. I'll never be part of any peace time of yours. I'm going far away from here. I will make a world that is fit for a man to live in, where he can be free and have a chance to do what he wants, some way. Hey, let's try again. Try again.
Try what? Living here. Speaking quietly to all the old men like you. Standing like a sheep on the street corner until the red light turns green. Being a good boy and a good sheep, like all the ideas you got out of these fucking books. No. I will make a world
How can you make a world that's fit for everyone to live in unless you first reward it yourself? Mark my words, young man. I shall keep following you until my last breath. I shall follow you to the far corners of this earth. You and I want the same thing. But until you can think of something that everyone has a right to, you are my deadly enemy, and I will destroy you. I hear your mother in the kitchen. Have you seen her?
I have no mother. Get it into your head. I don't live here.
Then why did you come here? Out of the whole world of Jerusalem, why did you come to this exact place? 216 Cedar Street, Excelsior, Texas. Well,
what if I did? What if I wanted to look it over one last
time? Oh, you're related, all right. But when your mother comes in, you must behave yourself. You
what?
Must be.
What must? Must behave yourself? Don't you say must to me.
Quiet.
Nobody can say must to me. My whole life, everyone has been crossing me. Everyone. Everything. All of you. I will be free even if I have to kill half the world for it.
Right here, too. Let me get my hands up.
Stop! Stop!
Oh my
God!
Listen, my father used to beat me and lock me up every Saturday night. My own father never gave me enough to eat.
I never had enough to buy decent clothes. I was ashamed to go downtown. I never went to any of the dances. My father and my uncle put rules in the way. Everything I wanted to do, they tried to prevent my living at all. Sorry.
No, say it all.
Well, in this scene, it's like I was back in high school, you know, where I was filled with the emptiness of being blocked and hated at every turn. Emptiness that fills you with the urge to fight and strike and kill. And it's like you have to kill someone else so you don't end up killing yourself.
That's not true. I knew your father, and your uncle, and your mother. None of that happened. You imagined all of that. They didn't lock you up.
They did! They did! They wished I wasn't even born.
That's not true.
Wait a minute. It's not wholly his fault that he wants to strangle me in this scene. He wouldn't want to do that unless he saw something inside me that made him want to do that. He talks about an emptiness. There's an emptiness inside me too. Yes, all I do is work and work. I've ceased to live. No wonder he feels that anger towards me.
Well, there, at least you've said it. We're all just as wicked as we can be. And that's the God's truth.
Come on, Emmanuel, let's go hang your head under some cold water.
No, I'll take it. I'm no longer. You guys have to go on with it.
Thank you for what you said, all of you. I will not lose myself in that place tomorrow, I promise.
It's okay, man.
George, do I see you limping?
It's just an old wound from the war. I'll manage.
I see some lights. The first in 7 years.
I'm tired, but I'm restless. Maggie, I've lost it. I've lost it.
What, George? What have you lost?
The desire to begin again, to start building.
It has to come back to you again, right? It has to, it will.
Maggie, it's just in this moment, all those people dancing around the bonfires, it's just relief. It's just a desire to start again, to slip into all the grooves, to keep the neighbors from walking on the lawn. During war, in the middle of all that blood, the dirt, the hot, the cold, every day and night, Maggie, I would think about what we could do after. During war, you think about a more peaceful life. When you're at peace, you think about a more comfortable one. I've lost it. I feel sick. I feel tired. The thought of you and the children. And Maggie, I didn't dare ask you. You didn't lose all my books, did you?
No, they're all around here. They're just a little tarnished.
Oh, yes. Maggie, do you remember when we almost lost these? In the middle of the war, when I was sitting on a hill in the middle of the night, I used to try to remember words and phrases from these books. They would come back to me. I would give them names, the hours of the night. 9 o'clock, I used to call Spinoza. Where is it? Has experience had taught me.
After experience had taught me that the common occurrences of daily life are vain and futile, and I saw that all the objects of my desire and fear were in themselves nothing good nor bad, save and so far as the mind was affected by them, I at length determined to search out whether there was something truly good and communicable to man.
Then tell me, O Creus, how will a man choose a rule that shall rule over him? Will he not choose a man who has first established order in himself, knowing that any decision that has its spring from anger or pride or vanity can be multiplied a thousandfold in its effects upon the citizens?
This good estate of the mind possessing its objects and energy we call divine. This we mortals have occasion, but in it is pleasantest and best. But God has it always. It is wonderful in us. But in God, how much more wonderful?
In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth was waste and void. And on the face of the earth was death.